The charter to which you referred mentions that the two countries, the United States and Ukraine, share a vital interest in an independent, sovereign, and unified democratic Ukraine. The words of vital interest in the United States have special meaning. Traditionally, they were associated with a treaty such as the NATO treaty or the U.S.-Japan treaty. In the Carter administration, President Carter gave a speech at one point and referred to the Persian Gulf as being a vital interest of the United States, even though there was not a treaty relationship. And this caused quite a stir at the time. So the words vital interests have special political meaning in the United States. How do you interpret those words? For example, would you expect that that would mean that if Russia were to undertake a military activity against Ukraine, say in Crimea, that U.S. military aid would be forthcoming?
Well, Ambassador, I'm a diplomat of the traditional school. So I tend not to interpret the views of the other side, leaving it to the diplomats of, in this case, of the United States. But I would presume, frankly, that this statement and these words, they reflect the acknowledgement by the United States of the special key role played by Ukraine in the region, and U.S.'s the interest of the United States to see this region, neighboring Ukraine, as a stable, secure, and a recognition of the importance of this region for the overall European security. That's my interpretation of those words.
Thank you. U.S. And European countries have been reluctant to get involved in the internal politics within Ukraine. Some leaders in Ukraine have called for the U.S. and Europe to help encourage political reconciliation or help find a way to achieve political reconciliation within Ukraine. Do you expect that the U.S. Would be interested in doing something like that, or would the U.S. prefer to have the Ukrainian leaders resolve political issues themselves?
Well, again, it's extremely difficult for me to say what will be the intentions of this administration and the United States in general. I do believe that Ukrainian problems are to be solved and can be solved only by the Ukrainians. Where U.S. Assistance is definitely welcome is in the in further development and strengthening of the democratic institutions in Ukraine, in furthering cooperation in many fields that are so important for Ukraine and the United States.